Okay, good morning, Bio Education students, and good morning, model class.
Good morning, Mr. Sarai.
Thank you. Please sit down. All right. Much of that, the topic that we have gone through, and we have seen something on work. Work is done especially when an object or let's say a force has to move through a certain distance. Okay, so the amount of work done should also depend on the, what does it depend on? Mary. Okay, there are basically two things. All right, one is a distance, and secondly, the force, okay? So these two things will determine the amount of work that is done. All right, in this lesson, we will go through and do some calculation, especially on work. There will be some problems given to you. You can go through and solve that. But before we go on to these activity questions or the problem that I will give you, let's have a look at some general example. Right. Our question is, does a force always do work? Who is going to answer that question? Suleiman.
The answer to the question, no, force does not always do work. It only does work when it moves.
Okay, not all the force. That is very good. Not all the force will do work. Okay, in some cases, force may do work, but in others, there won't be any work done. Now, in answering that question, okay, we can now have a look at some other example. Okay, we have these two wrestlers. Okay, if nobody has to move a certain distance, probably no work will be done. So, in this case, one will be struggling all his energy out in order to force somebody down or move him from one point to the next. But if they are there for certain reasons in a certain place, there won't be any work done. Okay, that is one example. Right, I'll come back to you and then give you, probably if you want to take down a notes, I'll give you that later. All right, having to look at this machine which is moving through, pushing, especially if it is moving from one point to the next, okay, we can say that work is done, okay, that case. Now, also, looking at how much work is done, especially when that our friend there is lifting. Okay, there is a heavy weight which is four. The work done by this person is simply, okay, let's see when it is down here. Okay, that is the force which is given as mass times acceleration due to gravity. Okay, that gives you the weight force. But if this weight lifter has to lift this from that point up here, okay, that is the distance it has moved. We can now calculate the amount of work that is done, and that is force times distance. Okay, the force is given by this mass times acceleration due to gravity. And if that is the case, it will be about 1,000 newtons. And if that certain height is given, that is the amount of work that is done. All right, I'll give you the notes later on. Okay, that is in explaining what we have just gone through. Given by that formula, okay, force times distance, right, in this case, The height was 2 meters. So we almost have about 2,000 joules of work that is done. All right, I will now go through. Okay, you can copy the notes if you want to, right? Example of that. Okay. All right. Okay, I will give you the example too. Alrighty, here is the given it by the formula work equals to force times distance, and then you have the distance which is 2. And the force applied would be 1,000 newtons. How did we get that 1,000 newtons? Maima, how did we get that 1,000? Okay, so the mass of that was 100 kilograms. So in order to find the force, or let's say the weight of that, weight is simply the force. So that is mass times acceleration, or mass times the 10. And that gives you 1,000 newtons. Okay. Are you finished with all right, your activity for that would be simply to copy the data that I will give you now. Okay, simply for the load and also the distance in which that crane operator is trying to move the cargo from one point to the ship. So here are the table of some of the data. What you can do is to complete for each one of those spaces given, and then we can go through and mark those activity questions together. Okay, for the question, you can find that the load that was lifted, and then you find some of the spaces missing. So you have to write in the values. All right, quickly copy the next. Right. Once you finish taking those down, you can compute to come up with your answers. Right, for the first part of the table, and then you have the next part. Now there are six of questions, or in other words, six of those tables that you can fill in. Load is the same thing as the weight or
so it's already
the same thing.
So it's not a mess.
It's not a mess. Okay, good question here. The question is the load the same thing as a mess? Okay, the load is the? Okay, it is a weight or the force, weight force. Okay. Mass is simply given in kilogram. The load will be in? Newtons, okay. That's the force, okay. Is just giving you the load. Okay, another term for force or the weight would be the load. Okay, it is not, mass will be given as mass. Okay, and it is in kilogram. The load will be in newtons. Okay, it is another name for the weight force. put the answers down already. Finisher. Okay. One, two, three. Maybe I will ask you to go in and explain your answers. Okay, you write your answers and then one, two, three, four, five. The first six. One, two, three, four, five, six. Okay, all of these will be yours. You can start working out on the side if you want to. With need explanation, you can do that. Okay. Just to show your friends what you've done or how you've arrived in those senses. Okay, shall we go through and have a look at these answers? Okay, so I will now ask the SAM students to go out and then show that they're working out on the board. If you have finished writing the answers, you can go through and explain your answers, how you arrive with those answers. So our first two questions, I will be asking John and Mark, okay? Yes. Check to see if the mark is on.
I use the formula work equals force times distance, 2 times, 2 meter times 5,000 the load in newtons, came up with 10,000 joules.
Okay, 10,000 joules. Okay, do not forget to write that down. Capital letter J at the end.
Given by the formula, work is equal to force times the distance. The force, 10,000 newtons, also known as the load, times 4 meters, you get 40 joules.
Sorry, 40,000 joules.
Okay, so in here you can simply going through using the formula that is force times distance, and then 10,000 times 4 would be 40,000 joules, or it can be 40 kilo joules. Okay. Suleiman.
The formula given to work out work is force times distance. In our question, we know what the work is. We know what the work done is. It's 40,000 joules, and the force is unknown, but the distance is also known, 10 meters. So we substitute, we get F is equals to 40,000 over 10, which is the work over the distance, and we find what the force is, or load, which is 40,000 newtons.
Okay, the work done will be 40,000 joules, but in there, the distance moved will be 10. So that is why we have to calculate this, then we'll have to find the subject of the formula that is force. Force equals to mass times acceleration, you swap the formula, and then you get force, which is 40,000 divided by 10. Then you arrive with this 4,000. Newtons. Okay, moving on to the next.
Since the work is given, it's 900 joules, and the work, the newton is the force is 6,000 newtons, and the distance is unknown. So to find the unknown values, so to make the extra subject, it goes to 900 over 6,000, which equals 0.15 meters. Thank you.
Okay, I'll just fix this. Okay, this one will be. Okay, next.
To find the work, and we are given the force is 5,000 newtons and the distance is 2 meters, so we multiply 5,000 by 2 and we get 10,000 joules.
Last. Right, the answer will be for the last question was okay, 5,000 times 2 will give you 10,000 joules.
Asked to find the force, so you simply transpose the formula work equals force times distance. You'll come force equals work over distance. The work done was 90,000 joules divided into 3.6 was meters. You'll arrive with force equals 25,000 newtons.
Okay, if the force is 25,000 newtons. Alright, let's go through and then have a look at this question. Alright, all we have done is to go through and then fill in those missing spaces in the table. Basically, in this, for this question, I will be going through and then probably we will work together to solve that question. Alright, you find that the student has to lift an exercise book weighing 10 grams from the desk. Calculate the work done in lifting that book 20 centimeters, right? If, tell me, how do we solve that question? Okay, Michael, how do we do that?
Kilograms, so that will be 0.01 grams, and you convert centimeters to meters, and you multiply the converted answer of the grams to the kilograms. You can multiply it by 10, and then you multiply, you get the answer, and you multiply that by the distance, the converted distance.
Okay, good. That is how we can solve that question. Okay, good morning, pilot education students, and good morning, model class.
Good morning, Mr. Director.
Thank you. Please sit down.